Hello friends, I am dietitian Shilpa Chawla. So, winters are there. I really admire this weather because we can eat superfoods and we can wear beautiful clothes and we really look good in winter clothes. So today, I'll be talking about all the foods, fruits, vegetables, everything that we should eat during winters so that we can maintain our immunity, have good skin, good hair and good health. Our ancestors and grandparents have taught us to change the type of foods that we eat whenever there is a weather change. So in winters, we are supposed to eat foods that give you warmth, that give you more immunity. During winters, arthritis patients feel pain because of inflammation and there is problem of dry skin, eczema and psoriasis. Desiki give you instant energy, instant warmth. It has become a problem or a taboo to have ghee because we feel that it gives weight gain. But if you are having good fat, then it does not lead to weight gain. So how can we include pure desi ghee in our diet? So we can make tadkas of dal of pure desi ghee. We can apply desi ghee on chapati. But be aware, if you're not taking desi ghee in a limited amount, it can lead to different problems. So desi ghee is good, but used in a quantitative manner. Second is amla, the Indian gooseberry. If we start talking about the importance or the quality of amla, it's endless. So we should include amla in our diet. So how can we include amla in our diet? We should start taking amla candies if you're not diabetic, or we can make a fresh amla juice. We can make vegetable juice and include amla in that. We can always use amla for making tomato purees for different vegetables we are using in daily life. As we all know, amla is rich in vitamin C and it increases immunity. So during this COVID period, it is amazing to have this small amla, which is Indian gooseberry, and it has millions and millions of benefits. Thirdly, it's chikki. In winters, we find chikki everywhere. But the sad part is, commercially what we get chikki is made of liquid glucose, white sugar, dextro or maltose. So I would suggest that we should make the chikki at home. There are various recipes available in YouTube, but it's very easy to make. We can actually melt jaggery. We can put sesame seeds. We can put peanuts. There are almonds. We can use any amount of seeds we want to. And we know sesame seeds have lots and lots of quality. It is rich in calcium, rich in fiber, and again, it gives lots of warmth. Sesame seeds also help in increasing hemoglobin. If your hemoglobin levels are low, you'll feel even more colder. So it's better to include sesame seeds in your diet, and that can be very well done by using sesame seeds in jaggery and making a chikki at home. So fourthly, in winters, we can use different kind of flours like maize flour, we can use millets, we can use bajra or pearl millet. These are rich in good starch, they give you warmth, they're full of fiber and they're gluten-free. They are rich in protein, they are good for cholesterol. So we can always make chapati in winters using these flours. Now in winters, we generally make panjiris. So panjiris can be made from sattu, from moong dal flour. So it has a lot of, it gives lot of instant energy, lot of warmth, because it includes nuts, cardamom, fennel seeds, all kinds of seeds, pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds. We use gond also. So we make gond laddus also, which is so energetic. It gives you instant energy, lot of warmth and full of calcium and protein. So we have a habit of criticizing Indian food. Indian food is the best food. Western countries now in COVID period, they are basically copying what we used to do for making our curries using turmeric, using cinnamon, using cardamom. So now, if Indian food was bad, why are they copying us? Actually, Indian food becomes bad when we overdo it, when we don't stop eating at a limited point. No food makes you fat. It's your lifestyle that makes you fat. If you're eating and if you're not burning, then definitely any food will make you fat because it will get stored. So rather than having sedentary lifestyle, it's better that we should have a routine of doing 1 hour exercise, controlling our carbs and eating food which is seasonal and which is suitable for your health. If our Indian food was bad, and if we look at the history, our ancestors, our grandparents, they used to eat same food, and they had sweet panjiri laddus, gond laddus after every meal. But they never had diabetes, they never had any CVD problems, and they were more fitter and slimmer than us. It's only because they used to work hard. They had their own schedule, they were walking more, they had their lifestyle which was using their more energy, and they were burning their carbs constantly as they were eating. We can still include all these things in our diet, but in a limited quantity. But we have to get away from the sedentary lifestyle and make yourself more active. So turmeric has the benefits of reducing the inflammation for the arthritis patient. It is amazing. It helps in reducing pain, and it gives a lot of warmth in winters. So next thing which is beautiful in winters is the green garlic. So it is amazing for heart increase. It reduces the cholesterol, triglyceride. It is an anti-inflammatory, it is antibacterial. So we can include a green garlic in our daily routine, in our food, in the curries. So lastly, I would like to suggest the concoctions that we can have in winters. We can make concoctions of jeera, ajwain, sauf, and we can put raw honey into it. Also, tulsi and ginger concoctions. If we talk about the benefits of tulsi, we can make another video of it. Because tulsi is antiviral, antibacterial, anti-inflammatory. So we should include tulsi in winters in lots of things. We can make our normal masala chai by adding ginger and tulsi, which keeps you away from different infections because it is antiviral and antibacterial. Also, there is haleem, which is called the garden cress seeds. We can soak them overnight. We can use them in smoothies. We can put them in curd. And they give you instant energy again. They give you a lot of warmth. So thank you so much for being with me. I hope I'll be able to make more videos which are more informative for you. Thank you so much.